asleep with you in the desert tonight. With a billion stars all around. Cause I got a peaceful, easy feeling. And I know you won't let me down. Cause I'm already standing. But she can take you anyway. You don't already know how to go. Cause I got a peaceful, easy feeling. And I know you won't let me down. Cause I'm all as a lover and a friend. But this voice keeps whispering in my other ear, tells me I may never see you again. Cause I got a peaceful, easy feeling. Yes, I'm already standing on the ground. Ooh, 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 oh, oh. Ooh, 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 oh, oh. Live from my basement, it's Tuesday Live. I'm going to go right back to the start here, folks. This is a bizarre. It keeps muting on me for some reason. I'm not sure why that's doing that. Okay, we're back. Oh, the prairie lights are burning bright. Chinook wind is moving in. Tomorrow night I'll be Alberta bound. I couldn't, my old luck ain't been so good. Tomorrow night I'll be Alberta bound. No one I met could ever forget the Rocky Mountain sunset. It's a pleasure just to be Alberta bound. And I long to see my next kin to know what kind of shape they're in. Tomorrow night I'll be Alberta bound. Everyone out there in internet land, as our good friend Robbie O'Spoon always says. My name's Rob Witherspoon. If you're new to the show, I'm not sure who's all here tonight. I see folks checking in. I saw Lee from up in New York checking in, as well as Kathy, Stan, and Emily Ann, and who else is there? Anybody else there? I haven't seen you. Putty, yeah, Putty from Long Sioux. Good to see you, Putty. Thanks for tuning in tonight. A bit of a different show, and I'd like to... It's a live show. It's all live tonight, folks. I'm giving the whole cast time off, and we'll see if I can survive an hour here. And the reason I'm doing this is that in a few weeks, 3 weeks, I guess, I'm playing my first big live gig in a while. I played a bit last summer. I played a couple gigs and played for one of my own alumni events, but I've got a big private event. I think there's going to be about 500 people there or so, 500 or 600 people, in a big building at the University of Waterloo. And it's kind of cool because I plug right into the building sound system and they play through the whole building. They're on multiple levels, so it's kind of fun. That's why I'm testing this system. What I have here, for I know there's musicians out there watching the show, but I have this is kind of my live rig, what I was using prior to the pandemic. And I've used it a few times on the show. But it's my live ring, and I'm still sort of fiddling around with the sound. So let me know what you think of the sound. This vocal right now sounds a little flat or something, but I do have I can put a little reverb on, which beefs it up a bit, but leaves a bit of echo. I don't know if it's better with the reverb or not. I'm sure my mom will tell me because she's listening. But hey, Nelson, good to see you. Thanks for checking in, and everybody else who's out there. But anyway, so what I'm doing tonight is just woodshedding, is what musicians call it, where you're picking some tunes or you're thinking about playing for a live show and working on them a bit and trying to get them worked up for a live presentation. And obviously, I'm not just doing that tonight. I've worked on these a bit over the years in particular. But they're ones I'm pulling out, and I'm going to talk a little bit about how I think a live show goes together and some of the things I've learned from reading from other people and looking to see how shows are designed, because it's a big thing getting up and playing music and certainly when you're on a live stream like this, you're kind of limited. I'm kind of got limited space here. I noticed my curtain there is a little off at the bottom there. I'm not sure what happened there. My camera must have got jarred or something. But but when you're on a live show, you want to make it interesting, and that's a big part of it is trying to make the show interesting. And that start, the way I started the show, I usually start with a song I'm really comfortable with. And typically what I do is, you play something, put a big trash can ending on it, which is that big kind of like that, and hope someone in the audience picks up a little bit of applause or something, and then as people are applauding, you kick right into the second song, which is usually another good song as well. And the way it was described to me by the fellow, there's a guy named Tom Jackson, who's a live show producer out of Nashville, and I've read a lot of his, I've actually bought a book that he produced on live shows, and he talks about when you're meeting an audience for the first time, and I know this audience I have out here, you've seen me a few times, but when you're playing in front of an audience a few times, it's kind of like a date. You're kind of starting out a relationship, so you don't want to jump in with something too heavy on the first song, something that maybe people will be familiar with, and something that's easy to play and no long breaks or anything. And so that's kind of what I do when I'm working on songs. And for the set, and then so you bring that up, and then so you're kind of you start with kind of an easier song that's easy to play. Then you go to a little bit. Maybe a little bit more up-tempo, get people moving, tapping their feet a bit more. And then right now I'm moving into one of my better songs. Of course, the way things are going tonight with muting and everything, who knows what's going to happen. But it's called Amy, a song I've been playing for a long time. And I get to use some of the magic of my little pedal down here, which I was just going to mention that earlier. It's a TC Helicon Voice Live 3. They're not making them anymore. They made them for a little while, and then TC Helicon got bought out by Behringer, which was unfortunate because TC Helicon is, a Vancouver-based company, and it's making some really cool stuff for solo acoustic musicians like myself to add a little bit more beef to your show, those harmonics, and I get some guitar effects, and it also has a little looper pedal, which I'm going to goof around with a bit tonight, and just warn you, it could get a little crazy here, but here's a song called Amy, and I'm going to try using the looper bit on this. We'll see how it works. Preset. One thing for yourself. Now you're off with someone else and I'm alone. I thought that I might keep you for my own. Amy, what you wanna do? I think I could stay. I do. And time is right for us to find. All of them things we thought weren't right could be right in time, and can't you see? Which way we should turn, together or alone? Never telling what is right or what is wrong. Don't you know it just takes too long? And Amy, what you wanna do? I think I could stay with you for a while, maybe longer if I do. Now it's come to what you want. You've had your way, and all of them things you thought before faded into gray. And can't you see that I don't know if it's you or if it's me? It's one of us, I'm sure we both will see. Won't you look at me and tell me, Amy, what you wanna do? I think I could stay with you for a while, maybe longer if I do, a little longer if it's true. Falling in and out.
It's a little Amy, a fun song, Pure Prairie League tune. I think I've done that in the show before. But anyways, let me know what you think of the songs. If there's any songs that you've heard over the course of, the many episodes of the show we've done here, 162 we're at, any songs that are particular favorites of you that you'd like to see in a live show, let me know. I'd love to do that. But, one thing about live shows, too, is trying to get the songs. It's not just kind of banging out the songs that, trying to make them sound exactly like Pure Prairie League played them or whatever. But, maybe taking a song, something that people are familiar with, and doing something a little different with it. Making some kind of special little moments in it. And that's what I try to work on. I think I'm getting better at it in terms of working with songs, working with your levels various tools that I have to make them a little bit more interesting. Thanks, Lou. Good to see you here tonight, Lou. Lou often watches the show a little later, and nice to see you here live tonight, Lou. And see Shauna here as well. Thanks for checking in, Shauna. And I see you're trying to share the. If you want to invite your friends to come watch the show, always fun to watch the show. Always have a lot of fun with it. I'm going to show you a little bit of technology here. I'm going to show you. I work with a green screen here. Behind me I have a green screen. This is a little studio I work in. I'm letting you know all my secrets tonight. And then I work with the camera, but the problem with the green screen is I have to trim it or I lose my paneling at the back. So I'm going to trim my photo here. Just hold on. There we go. I got rid of that. Was really bugging me, that little bit of. But now I've got this over here. It's always a problem. I'm spinning myself on screen. That's this live thing. It's much better when you're doing it on a stage. You have more space to work with. I can barely stretch my arms here. I guess I'm going back a bit. I could. But But, this is what they call the musical different moment in the show. A dark desert highway, cool wind in my hair, a warm smell of Kalitas rising through the air. Up ahead in the distance, I saw a shimmering light. My head grew heavy and my sight grew dim. I had to stop for the night. There she stood in the doorway, heard the mission bell. I was thinking to myself, this could be heaven or this could be hell. Then she lit up a candle and she showed me the way. There were voices down the corridor. I thought I heard them say, welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place, such a lovely face. Plenty of room at the Hotel California. Any time of year, any time of year, you can find it here. Her name's Tiffany Twisted. She's got the Mercedes Benz. She's got lots of pretty, pretty boys that she calls friends. How they dance in the courtyard, sweet summer sweat. Some dance to remember, some dance to forget. So I called up the captain, please bring me my wine. Haven't had that spirit here since 1969. And still those voices are calling from far away. Wake you up in the middle of the night just to hear them say, welcome to the Hotel California. Such a lovely place, such a lovely face. Living it up at the Hotel California. What a nice surprise, what a nice surprise. Bring your alibi. Mirrors on the ceiling, pink champagne on ice. She said we're all just prisoners here of our own device. And in the master's chamber, gathered for the feast, they stab it with their steely knives, but they just can't kill the beast. Last thing I remember, I was running for the door. I had to find the passage back to the place I was before. Relax, said the nightman, we are programmed to receive. You can check out any time you like, but you can never leave. Was fun. A little bit of the Eagles there, which are always popular song to do on live shows. And David Ward signing in from Norris Point, Newfoundland. I've been wondering what that fella from Away is doing out away there. But good to see him here. But yeah, what I'm thinking of doing is the next three shows or so, counting this one. Hey, Waxy's here too. Good, Waxy, you're kind of on the next song. I've got a bass. I got a bass player on this next song. I'm calling him Virtual Waxy. You're gonna say Waxy plays better than Virtual Waxy. I'm sure that's true. But anyways, what I'm doing for the next few shows is I'm kind of woodshedding some songs. A lot of songs you may have heard before, but some songs I'm pulling out. And I'd love to hear your ideas for songs or what you like when you go to see a live show. What sort of things entice you? I know a lot of live shows. Like, I know this, you know, I'm playing at an alumni event at a university, a big, you know, 500, 600 people. And I know of those 500 or 600 people, probably none are coming to see me. They're coming to see their buddies from back in whatever, in 2003, 1993, 1983, 1973. I'm trying to think of how far back I have to go with music. Like, will the 53s be there? You know, they might be. You know, my mom was a 52. And there's lots of 52s out there, lots of the 50s grads, so we have to dig back and play some older tunes, but I try to, you know, think of my audience and realize also that for an event like this, I'm just the guy in the corner playing some music. But what's cool is in this big building, it's a giant university building, like they have their robotics research lab and everything there, and I plug into the wall, and some guy not even in the same building, they have to call him on a phone or something, and he pipes it through the whole building so people can hear me throughout this building. So I'm sure a lot of people hear me play and will never see me. But, David, how do you even know I'm wearing pants? You know, sometimes, you know, for live shows, I might have to put on pants now, but when I'm a Tuesday Live, I'm usually playing just from the waist up. So you can probably imagine me in really tight leather pants, couldn't you? But I'm going to play a tune here, which is, you know, this is a musical moment as well. I'm doing a little variation on a song that you probably might have heard Rob Dylan do. Loop, but I'm going to work with it. Mama, take this badge away from me. I don't need it anymore. It's getting dark to see. I'm knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. Take these guns and bury them in the ground. 'Cause I can't shoot them anymore. That long black cloud is a coming down. Feel I'm knocking on heaven's door. Oh boy, like Waxy says, new toys, and I'm enjoying them. It's always fun having. This isn't actually a new toy. This is an old toy, a very old toy. I've had it for a while, and I'm just really still learning how to use it. And over the pandemic, I kind of didn't. You know, I probably should have used it more. But I was doing the show, and I sort of simple just to plug things in and go and play, and everything went really well. But I thought. There's a lot you can do with this for live shows, and that looping thing I have to get onto a little more. So you're going to see more of that, some bad looping. Maybe I should call it the Bad Looping Show. But we're having fun here on Tuesday Live. Got a nice audience out there. It's and like I say, if you have any suggestions, like what do you, I mean, other than David Ward talking about wardrobe, I guess David Ward, why wouldn't he talk about wardrobe? That's what his people do. He's from a long line of Ward robing people, but it is so if you have any questions, well, thanks Lou, that is a great tune. Knock knock knocking on heaven's door. If anyone's on Facebook, any I know there's lots of musicians that watch. No, lots of musicians, there's a few musicians that watch the show, but there's a new Facebook group called Solo Acoustic Musicians. There's a guy who's written a book about solo acoustic musicians. I've read it. And he started the Facebook group, and it's quite cool because they've got these solo musicians from all over the world, I think, are commenting, and it's quite active right now, starting up, and people talking about, you know, the challenges of being a solo acoustic musician, like not getting paid. Like apparently there's some bar down in Texas that's asking solo musicians to pay $100 to get on their list to be considered for playing in that bar, which, how many jobs do you have to register to even think? With an organization to get to even get a job, I guess maybe some registered things, but musicians are not like that. But anyways, this is supposed to be the big fun moments. This is where you get up and sing, I guess, if you want. Do I dare try to loop? South to the land of the pines, and I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina, staring up the road, pray to God I see headlights. I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers, and I'm hoping for rally I can see my baby tonight. Rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Running from the cold up in New England, I was born to be a fiddler in an old-time string band. My baby plays a guitar, I play the banjo now. Oh, the North Country winters keep getting me now. I lost my money playing poker, so I had to up and leave. But I ain't a turning back to living that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. trucker out of Philly had a nice long toque, but he's a-heading west for the Cumberland Gap to Johnson City, Tennessee. Well, I gotta get a move on fit for the sun. I hear my baby calling my name, and I know that she's the only one. And if I get to rally, at least I will die free. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, mama, rock me. I said, Wagon Wheel, always a fun song to play. Maybe overplayed? I don't know. Is Wagon Wheel overplayed? It's a question for the folks out there. But if you have any requests or any comments or any comments about the sound, because I'm sort of I'll tell you, it's an interesting rig. And what I'm planning to do, I'm trying to go really light when I go to the show because it's a bit of a move in. You have to go up a bunch of stairs and stuff, and being a solo musician, you don't want to take too many trips. One is ideal. So I'm planning to bring my little pedal board here and my mic. And I can actually, I've got a little guitar cord for those musicians. I got a little guitar cord that has a 1/8 stereo plug on it that goes to my in-ear monitors. And it goes down and plugs into my pedal. So I'm actually getting the feed off the pedal. So it was a little unnerving because I started the show and I had the countdown timer going. And I sort of plugged in a few minutes before the show and before I went live. And I said, Joe, I can't hear the countdown timer. And I realized, yeah, the countdown timer's not coming through my pedal. It's coming through the main system here. So, and then I'm just plugged in through a DI into the computer and out into the world of the internet. And I also have, I mentioned a looper here. That looper's the thing that kind of, it's kind of you record your guitar and you can layer up and stuff over it. I'm trying to get better with it, but still working on it. It's a work in progress. But anyways, I think we've got our good friend Stan who's been out taking pictures as usual, and really appreciate that. So I'm going to kick it over here to Stan. He's got a bunch of fantastic shots tonight, so let's see if we can make this work. I'm going to have to go through the dandelions first. Had the field of dandelions I forgot to change. And that's the. Oh, well, before I go to Stan, let's just back up, because Stan, I think, would be part of this. Is one thing I can do live is I can do these back images, because you want to make things different. It's kind of boring if I just stood in front of the paneling the whole show, but I can mix it up a bit and have some pictures behind me, and I can have some pictures in front of me too, like these fantastic pictures from Stan. So kick it away. Take it away, Stan.